Hi friends, let us study the next topic, that is the Peninsular Plateau. Now before I start, what were the physiographic divisions of India? The physiographic divisions of the India was the Himalayas, the Great Plains, the Peninsular Plateau, the coastal plains of India and the island regions of India. That is, there are the island regions, Andaman Nicobar Islands and the Lakshadweep Island regions, also some of the islands in the Narmada and the Narmada Tapi Delta and the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. Blue color is the peninsular, blue color is the plains of India, these are the lines of Himalayas. And the shaded black color is the Peninsular Plateau region. If you look at the Peninsular Plateau region, now what are the points you should remember for the examination? Peninsular Plateau is huge, and NK lectures also will be divided into numerous parts, which is both important for prelims exam and the mains examination. Again, with my lecture series, I will be discussing some past year questions or giving you hints that where you should focus here. Now, the Peninsular Plateau, as you can see here, first thing, why peninsula? The name peninsula means an area of a land which is surrounded by sea on the three sides. And because this is a roughly triangular land which is surrounded by the Arabian Sea, which is surrounded by the Bay of Bengal, which is surrounded by the Indian Ocean, on the three sides it is known as a peninsula. And because it is a flat table land, this shaded, black shaded region is at a greater height as compared to the red dotted region, it is known as a peninsular plateau. Peninsula because it is surrounded by sea or water body on three sides, and plateau because it is a flat region with a greater elevation. Now, it is roughly triangular in shape. You can see it is roughly triangular in shape. It is the largest physiographic division of India. This you have to focus, which is the largest physiographic division of India. It is not the Himalayas, neither the plains, but the Peninsular Plateau region. It is the largest physiographic division of India. How large? Let us look at the figures. From the north-south extent of this Peninsular Plateau is 1600 kilometers, while the east-west extent of this Peninsular Plateau is 1400 kilometers. I guess you can see here, I have written it is 1400 kilometers. And the total area of this Peninsular Plateau is 16 lakh square kilometer. It is around 16 lakh square kilometer, and therefore it is the largest physiographic division of India, comprising of half the size of our country, while the other half is the Himalayas, plains, plus coastal plains, plus islands. One alone, the Peninsular Plateau is the remaining half of the India. So that it covers around half the size of India, therefore it is the largest physiographic division. What are the boundaries of this the Peninsular Plateau region? The boundaries of this Peninsular Plateau region is made by the Aravali. Listen to me, because the board will become very messy, so I won't write much, but you have an idea of how this is. It is bounded by the Aravali ranges. These hills are the Aravali ranges, and this Aravali ranges extends right up to New Delhi here, and therefore it is also known as a Delhi Ridge. It extends right up to New Delhi here, therefore it is also known as Delhi Ridge in this region. It is bounded by the Aravallis here. Then it consists of the central highland region, Marwar region in Rajasthan, from where the people who originated there are known as Marwadis. So the Marwar region, Malwa Plateau, Bundelkhand, Chota Nagpur Plateau, then the which is this range? Then the Vindhya mountain ranges. Then the Satpura mountain ranges. It is bounded on the west by the continuous mountain you can see here, which is the Western Ghat region. While on the east, the mountains here are known as the Eastern Ghat region. So this is the major part of the Peninsular Plateau. But what you have to remember, the northeastern part of the Peninsular Plateau is the Raj Mahal Hills. Is the Raj Mahal Hills. This blue red line I have shown here is the Raj Mahal Hills. And the northeastern extension of this Peninsular Plateau is known as the Shillong Plateau or Karbi Anglong Plateau. So this part is known as the Shillong Plateau or the Karbi Along Plateau. It is the Shillong and the Karbi Anglong Plateau. So the Peninsular Plateau ka extension or the part in the northeastern India is the Shillong Plateau or Karbi Anglong Plateau, or what you call as a Garo Khasi Jaintia Hill system. So Garo Hills, Khasi Hills and Jaintia Hills are the part of what? They are not the part of Himalayas. They are physiographically, geologically, they are the part of the Peninsular Plateau. And the Peninsular Plateau, the Shillong Plateau or the Karbi Anglong Plateau is consists of which mountains? Now I am showing you here Garo, Khasi and Jaintia Hills. So they consist of Garo Ji here, Khasi and Jaintia Hills. And or it is continuously known as the Shillong Plateau. So the Garo, Khasi and Jaintia Hills are the extension of the Peninsular Plateau, and they are separated by Rajmahal. Rajmahal Hills here, Garo, Garo Hills here. So the Shillong Plateau or the Karbi Anglong Plateau is separated from the main Peninsular Plateau by Rajmahal Garo Gap. Rajmahal Hills and Garo Gap. By Rajmahal Garo Gap. And what is there in this Garo Gap? What is there in this gap? You can see in this gap it is shaded blue in color. Why it is shaded blue in color? Because this Rajmahal Garo Gap is now filled up by the sediments which consist of the lower Ganga plain. It has been filled up by the sediments brought down by the Ganga river. It consists of the lower Ganga plains. So the Shillong Plateau, if I ask you, is it a part of the Peninsular Plateau? Yes. Is it a part of a Deccan Plateau? No, it is not an extension of a Deccan Plateau, because the Peninsular Plateau consists of many parts. That is the Marwar Plateau, Bundelkhand, Bagelkhand, then the Chota Nagpur Plateau, and this part of the Peninsular Plateau, which is the biggest part, which I am drawing my hand now, is the Deccan Plateau. This part is the Deccan Plateau, while this entire Peninsular Plateau, this entire part is the Peninsular Plateau. Inside the Peninsular Plateau, this part, which is bounded by the Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats and the Satpura region, is known as a Deccan Plateau. So the Garo, Shillong and Karbi Anglong Plateau is not an extension of this Deccan Plateau, but it is the extension of this Peninsular Plateau in totality. Deccan Plateau is just a part of a Peninsular Plateau. So it is a plateau in totality. Past year question, whether the Shillong Plateau is an extension of a Deccan Plateau. No. Past year question, whether the Shillong Plateau is an extension of a Peninsular Plateau. Yes. Are you getting it? What is Deccan Plateau? Deccan Plateau is the part of a Peninsular Plateau. My hand is a part of my body. It is not the part of my nose. My hand is a part of my body in totality. It is not the part of my ear or my nose or my mouth. It is not the part. Similarly, here, I hope you are getting it. It is a part of a Peninsular Plateau in totality, separated by Rajmahal Garo Gap. Why the name Rajmahal Garo Gap? Because of the presence of Rajmahal Hills here and the Garo Hills in this region. Now, what is the major tilt, or where the Peninsular Plateau is tilting? What is the elevation of this Peninsular Plateau? Tell me, where does the river Godavari originate? Godavari originates somewhere in the Western Ghats, flows and meets the Arabian Sea region, flows into the Bay of Bengal. Similar for Krishna, originates near the Western Ghats and flows into the Bay of Bengal. Similar for a major tributary of river Krishna, river Bhima. Similar for river Kaveri, originates here and flows into the Western, flows into the Bay of Bengal, to the eastern side of the India. Why is this there? Because the general elevation of the Peninsular Plateau is from the west to the east. That means the general elevation of the Peninsular Plateau, the Indian Peninsular Plateau, if this is the Indian Peninsular Plateau, it is slightly tilting towards the eastern part. How do we know that? We know, therefore, the major rivers of the Peninsular Plateau, including the river Mahanadi, including the river Subarnarekha, including the mighty Godavari, mighty Krishna, mighty Kaveri, all this originate right here on the near the western coast of India, in the Western Ghat region. But they travel this entire distance and they empty into the Bay of Bengal. Why is this so? This is because the general tilt of the land is to the eastern side. General tilt of the land is to the eastern side. Except, do all the major rivers of peninsular India till go to the eastern side? No. Except two rivers, that is River Narmada and River Tapi. River Narmada and River Tapi, these two rivers flow to the west. Why is this so? Because except the entire peninsular plateau tilts towards the east, except the rift valley through which the Narmada and Tapi flowing, that is tilting towards the west. So, if this is the peninsular plateau and if this is the rift valley which is of the peninsular plateau, the entire peninsular plateau is tilting towards the east while the rift valley is tilting towards the west. Yellow color, peninsular plateau, jisme se, what is flowing? All the major rivers. While the black color is the rift valley through which the river Godavari, through which the river Narmada and Tapi is flowing. So the general elevation is from west to east except the Narmada-Tapi rift valley. That means Narmada and Tapi flows through a rift valley which is tilting towards the west. What is the age of a peninsular plateau? How old is the peninsular plateau? We know that the peninsular plateau is a part of ancient landmass which was known as a Gondwana land. In fact, do you know the name Gondwana itself came from the Gond tribes which live in which states of India? In the Maharashtra region, in the Chhattisgarh region, in the Madhya Pradesh region of India. So the name came from the Gond tribe which inhabits that area, and therefore that land was known as a Gondwana land. Peninsular plateau is a part of a Gondwana land along with the Australia region, along with the Antarctica region, along with the Africa, along with the South America region. It was a part of ancient Gondwana land. And how is the ancient Gondwana land? Ancient Gondwana land. Ancient land is old land. If you remember your geomorphology, what are the relief features on the old land? It is generally flat, rocky terrain without having deep valleys or the mountains. Same applies for the peninsular plateau, except for some of the hill ranges of the peninsular plateau. So the peninsular plateau is extremely flat, rocky surface, boring senile topography, which is composed, and therefore it is an ancient tabular landmass. What is it? Is an ancient. Why ancient? Because it is a part of ancient Gondwana landmass. Why tabular? Tabular means how is the table? Table is a flat base top having steep sides. So, peninsular plateau is also flat topped having steep sides. What are the steep sides? One steep side is Vindhya Satpura. One steep side is the Western Ghat region. One steep side is the Eastern Ghat region. And therefore, as it is a flat tabular landmass having steep side, we are calling it as a plateau. So, it is an ancient tabular landmass composed of Archean, gneiss and schist. What is Archean? Archean is an age in the geographical history, geological history. Archean means archaic. What is the word Archean means? It is a derived from the word archaic. What is the meaning of the word archaic? Archaic means very old, ancient. And therefore, Yahaka stones, these are made up of Archean age. Therefore, they are composed of Archean, gneiss and schist. Gneiss and schist. Why gneiss and schist? Now tell me one thing. The older rocks will be mostly composed of sedimentary rock or the metamorphic rocks. The older rocks which came in at the birth of an earth, they were subjected to heat, they were subjected to pressure, and therefore these rocks are generally metamorphic rock. Same applies to the peninsular plateau because it is one of the oldest landmass in the world. Peninsular plateau, you remember, it is one of the oldest landmass in the world. Therefore, it is composed of Archean, gneiss and schist. Gneiss is a metamorphic rock derived from granite. Schist is a metamorphic rock derived from slate. So, it is composed of Archean, gneiss and schist. Apply your geology of India ka first lecture. Therefore, this peninsular plateau, because it is composed of Archean, gneiss and schist, what is it rich in? It is rich in metalliferous minerals. It is rich in iron. It is rich in gold. It is rich in copper. And therefore, most of the industries in India are located in this region. This region has the most of the industries in India. It is composed of Archean, Nice and Schist, and therefore most of the industries are located in this region. Now, does the entire peninsular plateau consist of Nice and Schist? Does the entire peninsular plateau, may this plateau, entire peninsular plateau, we have rich mineral deposits? No. Why not? Because using this red pen now. Because this part of a peninsular plateau, which I am shading, this part of a peninsular plateau, which I am shading now with the red in color, it was subjected to what? I will use one more color, blue, so that it remains more or less comfortable to you. Red, blue, this all the messy area which I have made now, it was subjected to volcanic eruption, basalt eruption. Why? Well, why? When it was passing over the reunion hotspot, during which period? During a period known as a Cretaceous period. So this part of a peninsular plateau was subjected to volcanic eruption during the Cretaceous period. It was subjected to a volcanic eruption during the Cretaceous period, and therefore, except for this Deccan lava plateau, majorly lies in the state of Maharashtra, and therefore it is also known as Maharashtra plateau. The entire other peninsular plateau is composed of Gneiss and Schist, while yahan pe this Deccan lava plateau is composed of what? It is known, it is composed of basaltic lava, which has now been converted into black soil region. Composed of basaltic lava, which is in the black soil. So, it is an ancient tabular landmass composed of Archean, Gneiss and Schist, except for the Deccan lava plateau. Now, if anything is old, how does the person becomes, as it becomes, he becomes old? Person generally becomes wise because of the knowledge of, because of many things, that is different thing. Why I am telling you, person generally becomes wise, person becomes calm, person becomes peaceful, as generally they become old, they become wise. Same you apply to the landmass. And because it is an old landmass, it is extremely stable landmass. It is mostly a stable landmass, stable in the terms of geography, in the terms of geology. What do you mean by stable landmass? That means in the peninsular plateau, you will not feel any tectonic activity. Rarely will you hear that the peninsular plateau is shaken by the earthquake. Rarely you will hear that the peninsula, in fact, there is no evidence in the history, as in the living history of the peninsular plateau, may there is a folding or faulting or the volcanic eruption. That means it is a tectonically stable landmass. Any plateau which is older, any plateau which is archaic, is a stable landmass. And in the peninsular plateau is an also old landmass, so it is a mostly stable landmass. What do you mean by stable? It has gone through a little structural changes. Obviously, some structural changes have occurred in the history. For example, there has been volcanic eruption. There has been rifting and faulting in this region. But in the living memory, it has gone through little structural changes. It has remained flat. It has remained calm. It has remained very stable. On other hand, Himalayas still are rising upwards at the rate of 5 centimeters per year. Himalayas mein aaj bhi earthquake occurs. So it is unstable. Why? Because this is the youngest part. Young people have more energy. Same is young plateau, young landmass has more energy. So it is using that energy. Old landmass is very stable. And we call any such old landmass as a shield. What is a shield? In the battlefield, you remember, they used to use shield to protect themselves. Dhal in Hindi. Shield. And how is the shield? Strong, stable. And therefore, it is the peninsular plateau is an example of a shield. So, one more question here. What is a peninsular plateau? composed of? It is composed of Archean, Gneiss, and Schist, except the Deccan Lava Plateau. Why? Because the Deccan Lava Plateau is composed of basalt, and this basalt has given rise to black cotton soil here. Second, which rocks in which era? Archean era. Archean rock structure. Third, what is the Peninsular Plateau an example of a shield? Yes. What do you mean by shield? Shield means any stable landmass that has gone through a little structural changes. It is an any stable landmass. Except yes, there have been the phases of faulting, faulting, volcanic activity. Faulting is recently seen here in the Bhima Valley region. We will do that later on, resulting into, if you remember, the people from, at least from people from Maharashtra who are watching my lecture, they may be remembering the Latur earthquake. But otherwise, the Peninsular Plateau does not have a major history of an earthquake, except for the Latur earthquake. So, even if you forget this part, it does not matter for the examination. So, these are the important points of a Peninsular Plateau, the oldest, biggest landmark consisting of Archean rock structure, separated from the extension known as the Shillong or Kargi along Plateau by Rajmahal Garo Gap, through which the river Ganga flows. It is an example of a shield. Any shield anywhere in the world is rich in metalliferous minerals. Similarly, Peninsular Plateau is rich in metalliferous minerals, except in the regions now which has been covered by volcanic eruption. That is, this is the region which is covered in the black cotton soil. Now, how are we going to study the Peninsular Plateau? We will divide the Peninsular Plateau, and we won't study the entire Peninsular Plateau. I will focus on the areas which are important, which have the potential of being asked as a question in the general studies question paper or in the question paper. So, you won't, if you look at the past history, if you look at the importance wise also, they won't ask you about Malwa Plateau, they won't ask you about Marwar Plateau, they won't ask you about Bundelkhand, Bagelkhand region. But yes, the questions will be on the Deccan Lava Plateau. The question will be on something of importance in the Karnataka Plateau. It can be on the Telangana Plateau. But maximum number of the questions comes from the hill regions of the Peninsular Plateau. So, how are we going to study the Peninsular Plateau? We will study the hills of the Peninsular Plateau. What are the hills? Aravallis, Vindhyas, Satpudas, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats. Most important, Western Ghats. Sat, along with the Western Ghats, I will also tell you their relative importance in terms of ecology, environment, hotspot, who declares the hotspot, so that there can be interrelation between the different topics. Always try to interrelate. That makes the subject interesting, and that makes your study and remembering very easy. So, how are we going to study? We are going to study the Peninsular Plateau. By dividing the Peninsular Plateau into the hill ranges of the Peninsular Plateau or hills of the Peninsular Plateau and the flat land, that is the plateaus of the peninsula. Hills, the important hills we are going to study is the Aravallis, Vindhyas and Satpuras, Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. And the plateaus, the plateaus are divided into the central highlands. The Deccan Plateau region, I am saying Deccan Plateau, not Deccan Lava Plateau, the Deccan Plateau region, and the Northeast Plateau region, that is the Shillong Plateau region, Northeast Plateau, that is the Shillong Plateau region. So, this is how we will study. From the next lecture, Aravallis, then Vindhyas and Satpuras, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats. Important wise, Aravallis, yes. Western Ghats, yes. Vindhyas and Satpuras, relatively less important. But yes, you should be prepared from all the angles. And the plateaus, the most important is the Deccan Plateau and the Shillong Plateau. Relatively, the central highlands are not of very important, even in geographical point of view. So you won't find questions coming from the central highland region. So let us enjoy our studies of the Peninsular Plateau. After that, same like Himalayas, we will end the Peninsular Plateau topic with the map pointing. But remember, it is again an important part. So again, enjoy the lecture series, and thank you very much.